see what they're doing. All right, gotta go in quiet. Distract them. Yeah, anyone else hear that? Good boy.
It wasn't even my turn on the duty roster.
Stay in the shrubs. They can't see me in there.
Got everything you need?
I don't know.
Getting hungry?
I'm now.
God, I hate this shit.
Yeah.
Jesus, this is taking forever.
I don't know if forever's a long time. Field note 000. After tracking a large moving group, estimated size of 500 to 600, we have confirmed the subject's hibernation location at...
Hey Doc, I see Site 23 on the roster for tomorrow. That us?
No, that's O'Brien.
Got it.
Shit, where was I? We have confirmed the subject's hibernation location at the High Desert Grotto, now designated Site 15. Trampling of grasses and plants at the entrance, and the presence of footprints, see attached photos, indicate the site has been used for some time.
Must be nice and cozy in there.
According to the motion sensor planted by Lieutenant O'Brien, approximately 447 subjects have entered the cave this morning. Recommend sending a follow-up team sometime after 1900 hours to assess the cave's interior and further assess conditions. Note to Dr. Anderson, your theory about the subjects devolving to a primitive state of nocturnal behavior is seeming more appealing all the time. End report.
Not going inside.
King O'Brien.
Did you hear me? Over 400 subjects, and these aren't just your regular run-of-the-mill freaks. These are stage three.
They're smelling like babies.
No, and I asked if you were going in.
Can't be.
Didn't say I was.
And these subjects are not sleeping. They're hibernating.
Bushes. I gotta keep to the
bushes. Ever woken up a hibernating bear?
No.
Ever woken up a hibernating freak?
Yeah, actually. I was one of the survivors at the White King Mine.
Jesus.
Someone tear my buddy apart like he was peeing. These suits protect you from a lot of shit. Not them.
Holy shit, Corporal. Jesus, I'm sorry.
That mission was foobar from the start.
Which is why we are not going inside there.
Think if I sealed up this cave, we'd, I don't know, knock down their population?
I don't know, Corporal. A lot of caves out here. Come on, let's get out of here.
Super cave. Yeah, right. Like anyone gives a damn.
Hear that?
Boozer, you there? Boozman, come back.
Deke, hey, I'm here.
We rode on a farewell. The Nero guy, the soldier, or whatever the hell he was, who took Sarah.
What are you?
He had an ID badge. What was the name?
Oh, God, O'Brien. He wouldn't shut up about it. All the way out to Three Finger Jack.
Okay, he's alive, Boozer. He's alive.
What are you talking about? We were there. The whole camp was wiped out.
No, I know that, but I heard... Okay, look. I went into their LZ, and they...
Wait, you went into their LZ? What the...
You just listen to me. I heard them over the radio. They were talking about a man named O'Brien.
Deke, don't.
I'm not, Boozer. I'm not. I'm just... Hey, get some sleep. Peeking out.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. The start of this living hell that is now our life came as a surprise to no one who was listening to me when shit went down. And I was one of the few. Most who spoke out against the feds, well, things didn't go so great for them. The cemeteries are filled with martyrs. Those who sought to call out the bullshit and the lies when they saw it. I know, because they came after me. I started Radio Free Oregon in the last weeks before the feds fell. Broadcast from an unmarked van, moving from town to town. In the days before the roads came choked with cars and the bridges destroyed, trying in vain to stop the freaks. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
No cope, the cemeteries are filled with freakers, not martyrs. And you had to keep moving because if anyone had found your unmarked van, they'd have blown it to hell. Just... Another bounty. Okay.
Okay.